session today we are going to learn about pie charts, and I hope you have seen the previous videos which I have shared on the channel. And today we are going to discuss pie charts in details, and we will learn how we can draw a pie chart using the given set of data. So let us recall, pie charts are basically the circle graphs, and the information which is given to us is represented into sectors, because we need to divide the circle into sectors. And we know that the central angle of a circle is 360 degrees. So we are going to use this information for making the sectors, right? So let me share my screen with all of you, and we'll take you to one of the questions which we are going to learn today. So I hope you all can see this question. This is worksheet number 3, question number 1. It says, the number of trees of different fruits in an orchard are given below in percentages. And it says that draw a pie chart for the given data. So you can see we are given 2 rows. In the first row, we are given the names of the trees. And in the second row, corresponding to every tree, a number of trees in percentage is mentioned. So it says mango 50%, pear 20%, guava 20%, and papaya 10%. So you see that the total percentage is 100, right? And now we are going to represent this information in a pie chart. So first step which we are going to do is, we will be making the table having 3 columns. In the first column, write down the names of the trees, mango, pear, guava, papaya. And in the second column, write down the percentage, that is of number of trees, which is given. So 50% corresponding to mango, then pear 20%, then guava 20%, and papaya 10%, right? After that, we are going to find the sector angle corresponding to each of the item. So we see that mango is 50%. So we are going to find the sector angle using the concept 50% of 360. So 50 upon 100 into 360, it is 180 degrees. Similarly for pear, it is 20. So 20 upon 100 into 360, you can easily calculate. It comes out to be 72 degrees. Similarly, we calculate for guava, it is again 72 degrees, and papaya is representing 10%. So it is 10 upon 100 into 360, that gives us 36. So now we will be learning how we can make a pie chart. So let me take you to the tool where we are going to learn how to construct it. So first thing is, using the compass, you need to fix up some radius. So let me fix up some radius, and we are going to draw. Let me settle this. I think it is okay now. So first thing is, we are going to draw a circle. So you have the compass and pencil ready with you, so you can draw a circle. So that is the first thing which we have to do. After that, what we are going to do is, we will be marking any of the radius. So using a ruler and a pencil, you can draw the radius. Now let us see the information. So first we are going to make the sector for mango, and it says it is 180 degrees. So how we are going to do this? Take the protractor, and using the protractor, make the angle of 180 degrees. You know how to do this. Just fix up the center of the protractor on the center of the circle, And then you can see that here, let me first reduce the size of this. Yes, this is better. So now I can place it at the center of the circle. You see this point and the center point of the protector should coincide with the center of the circle. Now we need to make an angle of 180 degrees. So I'm using the pencil and using the protector, we can mark the point corresponding to 180 degrees. So take a pencil and mark this point, right? Now, remove the protector and using the ruler and the pencil, you can complete this line segment. And now you can see that this is 180 degrees. And this 180 degrees is making the sector. And we can write the name. This is mango. I hope it is clear to all of you how we have done this. Okay, after that, we will be making the next sector for the fruit pear. And we need to make a sector with sector angle 72 degrees. Now see how we are going to place the protector. So place the protector again at the center. And now see how we are going to rotate it so that we get an angle of 72 degrees. Just carefully see how I am doing it. Now I have set it to an angle of 72 degrees. And now I am going to mark the point. Yes. So you can remove this now. And with the ruler, you can use the ruler also. Right. We can now draw this and then you will get another sector. Now what is the sector angle? It is 72 degrees. I'm using online tool, so it is taking a little time, but you have the ruler at home, so you can easily construct it. Otherwise, here also, you know, you can draw the line segment. Oh, wonderful. Okay, so I'm going to make this line segment now. And this is 72 degrees. Okay, so now this is representing the second fruit, that is pear. So we have got the second sector. Now, what is the third one? So you can remove the ruler from here. Third one is guava, again, 72 degrees. Fine. So let us take this, put it at the center, and now we are going to rotate it and get an angle of 72 degrees. It's done. With the pencil, you can mark this point. Remove it. And with the line segment, you can join these points. And you get another sector of 72 degrees, angle 72 degrees. And this is representing the third item, that is guava. Next is the remaining portion. So the remaining portion is the fourth sector of angle 36 degrees, which represents papaya. So here it is 36 degrees, and this is representing the fourth fruit, which is papaya. See how easy it is to make a pie chart. So it's ready. Okay, so we have constructed this pie chart by using the information which is provided here. Now I'm giving you one question. The following table shows monthly expenditure of a family. Draw a pie chart for the data. And you are given the items: rent, food, clothing, education, others. An amount is given in rupees: 1500, 3600, 1200, 2100, 2400 respectively, for the items which are given to us, right? So you know how you are going to do this. So you are going to make three columns. First, write down the monthly expenditure, the items, and then in the second column, corresponding to each item, write down the expenditure in rupees and then find the sector angle. Now I am here sharing with you something very interesting. How you are going to find the sector angle? First, calculate the total expenditure. So you see that when we add these expenditures, 1500, 3600, 1200, 2100, 2400, we get 10,800. For getting the sector angle for rent, say for example, how we are going to calculate the sector angle. So 1500 is spent out of the total expenditure 10,800. So how the sector angle will be 1500 upon 10,800. So how much is in degrees into 360? Because the center angle of the circle is 360. So we need to divide it into different sectors. So we are going to find the sector angle. So 1500 divided by 10,800 into 360, and this gives us 50 degrees. So similarly, we are going to find the sector angles corresponding to food, clothing, education, and others. And then using the same process which we followed in the previous question, we are going to construct the pie chart. I hope it is clear to you. Try this question on your own. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Take care.